Here's how I repurposed this old router into a wireless AP. I recently bought this Lenovo ThinkStation P300 desktop PC, and I'm using it as my home server. I'm quite new to the home server home lab field. I installed Proxmox and only find out that Proxmox only support Ethernet connection. To be precise, it suggests avoiding wireless LAN network whenever possible. I have linked the documentation in the description. Since I will be placing the home server in my room and there's no Ethernet port here, I needed a solution. So it's time for my old router to shine, the TP-Link Archer C1200. I took out my old router and googled how to configure it. Turns out my old router is not officially supported. I came across a post on the LaoyaNet forum that mentioned TP-Link hides the options from the web UI. However, we can use the browser inspect function to modify the CSS and get it working. I have linked the post in the description. To do this, I needed to upgrade the router firmware. I have already done that using the latest EU firmware. Now I will configure the old router IP address. This depends on your network setup. My main router used 192.168.1.1. So this old router should using 192.168.1.2 as its IP address. You can use any usable IP address in your subnet. Log into the admin page, go to Advanced, Network, LAN, enter the IP address and save it. Next, I will use the inspect function on the old router admin page. Login back to the admin page with the new IP address. For my case, that is 192.168.1.2. Go to Advanced, System 2, System Parameters, right click and select Inspect. Use Ctrl plus F to search for the diff tag with the ID 5G_WDS_status. I'm using the 5GHz connection with my main router, but you can search for 2G_WDS_status if you're using a 2.4GHz connection. You should find the diff tag with the ID. Now remove the none from the style attribute and go back to the web page. Check the Enable WDS bridge box and click the survey button to look up the main router's Wi-Fi SSID. The security type is usually WPA-PSK or WPA2-PSK. Enter the password and save the settings. The last step is to disable the DHCP server. Go to Advanced, Network, DHCP Server, deselect Enable DHCP, and save it. After that, go to the Status section under the Advanced tab and click on 5GHz in the Wireless section. Then use the inspect function again and search for 5G_WDS_status. In the diff tag, remove the none from the style attribute. Go back to the web page and it should show WDS status run. The WDS bridge should be working now. Let's connect and test the network. My internet plan is 300 Mbps. I'm using the fast.com to do a quick test. My computer is now connected to my main router via Wi-Fi and the speed is normal as expected. Now I'm using the same computer connected to my old router via Wi-Fi and the speed is around 1/3 lower. It's not the best, but it's not bad either. Still better than having no connection. Okay, now I will plug the Ethernet cable into my home server and router. Then I can start playing around the home server. Thanks for watching. See you next time.